We are talking high voltage with Jamie in the new NVE Application Center. Jamie, give us the 411 on 1577, 61010, and 884.
We should explain that 1577 is a UL high voltage standard, 61010 is an IEC equipment standard, and 884 is VDE.
What's the difference?
All three standards have 1 minute destructive sample tests and 100% 1 second production tests. An important distinction: 1577 and 61010 are based on voltage breakdown, which is the voltage that causes high leakage current. But 884 and 6747 use partial discharge, so they are becoming more popular.
Partial discharge.
Right. Partial discharges do not completely bridge the isolation barrier, but they degrade the barrier.
How so, Jamie Moreno?
Small bubbles, or barrier impurities, can cause partial discharge. When a high voltage is applied, there is a discharge through the defect that damages the barrier, which makes the device more susceptible the next time. Eventually, the barrier can break down.
Holy Coulomb's bad girl. Breakdown tests can't detect these failures until it's too late.
Breakdown standards such as 1577 and 61010 are based on 1 minute breakdown voltage, so isolators cannot operate continuously at the rating. And it's not a measure of transient tolerance either. Like pressure testing a surgical glove, partial discharge tests uncover tiny imperfections that can grow.
So, lay down some numbers.
IsoLoop isolators have best-in-class partial discharge performance, including 600 working volts and 4000 volts transient overvoltage for all package types.
All package types, even MSOPs.
Absolutely. MSOP isolators are amazing.
What about folks who need wide bodies?
So, let's cover one more standard, IEC 60601. Which sets stringent rules for Creepage.
Wasn't Creepage a Radiohead song?
Not exactly. But most 16-pin wide-body SOICs do not meet the 8mm Creepage required under 60601 for 250 working volts. Ordinary JEDEC wide bodies have two tie bars.
I used to wear tie bars.
Well, these tie bars are tabs used in molding. Internally connected or not, the exposed metal reduces creepage. For an ordinary package, creepage is reduced below 8 millimeters.
And the true 8 package?
It's custom tooled, with tighter tolerances, and just one tie bar. But it's within JEDEC standards, so there is no special board layout or handling.
Are there other high voltage metrics of interest?
Other IsoLoop best-in-class high voltage metrics include barrier resistance, comparative tracking index, high voltage endurance, and barrier life.
Thanks, Jamie. How can viewers learn more?
Visit nve.com for application bulletins, or call us at 800 GMR 7141 extension 4.